California, Northern California, and Central California short track series. Okay, here we are inside the Cal Palace, San Francisco, California. This is just a look at the pits. You can see how many riders are here today. I think we have an estimated 300 to ride today. We have all classes, a lot of vintage bikes, just all kinds of old, neat two-strokes. No mini bikes here today. And we still have 300 riders, which is a great turnout. A lot of people we haven't seen in a long time. I'm gonna pan back here and see if I can lock somebody in. Everybody's behind the van. We'll get in on them in a second. Here we are inside Cal Palace, San Francisco, California.
Long time since we've raced here.
Now, if this track looks extremely small, that's because it is. It's probably about, we're pushing it when we say an eighth of a mile, maybe a 16th. And as you'll notice, there is no straightaway. It's one big circle. So this ought to be very interesting. The next thing you see, hopefully, will be practice. Okay, here's Brandon getting ready to go out and practice. This will be his first ride ever on a cement track. So I hope he just takes it easy, gets a feel for the track, and we hope most of all that the bike stays together. Talking?
I can hear you.
Okay. little louder.
Well, you didn't see me.
I didn't see you, but I heard Lodi.
Correct.
Coming up the track with the motor that was in more pieces than you started with. Smoke belching.
Bellowing smoke down the straightaway, and as I came out of turn two, I believe it was, dropped a valve smack into the top of the piston. It was still there when I took it out.
So you're here again this weekend, which means
we're in San Francisco. We're at the Cow Palace, the world famous Cow Palace.
Well, Thursday I was up 24 hours taking the whole piston with the valve in it out and putting together the new one.
Okay, so now we're at the Cow Palace, and this is a cement indoor.
Cement wrench.
First time on this type of track. What do you think?
It's a little awkward.
A little awkward.
No sliding.
And here's what happens to your steel shoe after two practices.
So we're gonna opt to ride without the steel shoe in the heat race.
We're gonna opt to go with tape only on the boot.
Tape only on the boot. How do you think you'll do in that heat race?
Just gotta get a good start.
Okay.
It's all about the good start.
Okay, well that's it for now. The next thing you'll see is Brandon's heat race, then we'll talk to him a little bit about it after that.
Possibly hopefully you'll see a clip of gear change.
There you go. Okay, until then, commercial break.
Changing more
come
gear.
In there and see how it went. Well, what'd you think?
Well, we got the bike working a little better.
What'd you do?
Got second.
Okay. What'd you do to the bike?
I made 2 teeth taller on the back. This way when you go in, it'll be like, air brakes.
Okay.
Air brakes. Just the air brakes.
Well, good luck, and we'll talk to you after the main event.
At the trophy presentation.
Yeah, it's a trophy presentation.
Did you see those?
Where? We're going to give you a panoramic view here of the pits inside the Cow Palace here on our West Coast Short Track Series. Almost 300 entries here today. And this is just the sportsmen. This evening, the pros will ride Kenny Roberts, Chuck Palmer, Rick Hawking, and many others. Hopefully, we'll get those on film for you. One more pan. See how far across we can go. Some of the other bikes. See if we can lock in the B-Meister. Back over this way. Right. There. He's getting ready. He's got a second to see his race, heat race. But he still has a second back row start. Not all the way back because there'll be three rows. He'll be in the second row back. Hopefully he'll pick a spot behind a faster rider so he'll get him right into the front. We'll see how that turns out in just a bit. So talks to Uncle Bob. Hey, we have 18 riders in this class, and the course looks like this. Now, I'm not sure if 18 riders can actually fit on this track.